There's turmeric in my hair. It's interesting. Interesting. Ooh. There's so many things that are interesting right now. There are some energies floating around. Floating all around, like I'm really feeling it. I'm sure you are too. This morning I was sitting and I thought about a friend. I was sitting and I was meditating and I thought about a friend. Just randomly popped up in my head, like, what's going on with her? And then I went inside and 30 minutes ago, it had been about 30 minutes since I had thought about her. 30 minutes ago, she was contacting me, saying, W, no, yeah, WYD. I don't even know. And I don't even know what I want to. YD, W, XY, yellow, blue, red, orange. But whatever the thoughts are is based upon my life. Your life is lessons. Looks like the cat's at the door. Your life is lessons, constant lessons, day after day. I just wish I could translate them. Translate the messages. But they're all speaking in my language, right? Right? But I'm noticing that my main mode role is open is expression. Like, I trained myself as a little kid. I was really into comics and movies and stuff like that, like any kid is. And I trained myself to be thinking in ideas and like ideas in order to draw, like create comics, panels, right? And I and so I mean that's all good, right? But part of me feels like it's limiting. Like the making of the art is limiting me. Like I could be, or the making of a video, or the making of like all these habitual like thoughts that I've had. Like I can't be expressing unless it's verbal or linguistic or writing down. It's like it's a constant novel inside my head. And lately, it's been a YouTube video. What's with that? What's with that? Yeah, I feel like it's limiting. Like, I could be. Like, it's limiting from my experience. I mean, it's good for other people. And that's good, right? To be serving, like, other people. Or, I mean, not serving them, just giving them energy. That's why I do it. To give you energy. He gives people energy to in turn, like, expand my energy. I don't even know. But I do know. I do know. I don't even know is just one of those words such as filler words. They're cool and all, I have nothing against them. I have nothing against it. Of course none of us know. But we're trying to know. And saying I don't know, sometimes, not always, can be an affirmation. Saying that you don't know. Like, I don't know. That could be limiting. All these things could be limiting us. All these things could be limiting. So, what am I imagining? What is my imagination wanting? My imagination is it's imagining something out of this world, something beyond all of this, beyond all of this physicality. And just like completely experiencing in my own mind that seems appealing. But is it really that great if I don't get to share it with the others? But wait, the others have their own experience that they're experiencing. Why do I have to put my experience into their experience? I've just been brainwashed by art. Like, I didn't. Some people always ask me, when did you get into art? Why do you like it? How did you get into it? And the thing is, it just happened. It's like there was no choice. But, you know, balance. I can close my eyes and, you know, have some spiritual experience, and then later I can tell people about it. Translation. Yeah. Okay. I guess that's what art is. That's what art is. Art is everything. Everything is beautiful. I wish I could experience everything rather than just what my circumstance is. And then I think, oh wait, I am experiencing everything. I'm experiencing an aspect of everything in which I'm only experiencing the perception of this vehicle. So yeah. What to do? Where to go, who to be, weird energy. are in my harmonica right now, so I'm just pretending. See, other people with other outlets speak, I mean, think in music. Like, I'll be thinking in like poetry or something, but like people who play the guitar and learned that from a young age, they think in music sometimes. That's amazing. How do you think? How do you think? Do you think in expressing, or do you think for yourself, or do you think for others? A little bit of both? Of course it's a bit of both. It's always a bit of both. It's always a bit of both. Both. Yeah, these energies today. That sounds ridiculous, does it? Does that sound ridiculous to say? To say these energies? Sort of. I don't know what is making me feel that way. It's probably the old programming. Lately, I've been deprogramming, like complete, like just realizing all of what the files inside of me that don't fit, and I am putting them to the trash. But of course, first you have to embrace them and look through them. Have a little bit of nostalgia. Yeah. Or you don't even have to put them in the trash. Just save them for later. Look at this. This is the cyber realm. The cyber realm was created here in this realm, and it's seeping in, and we are becoming it. We are becoming cybers. This is cyberspace. Back. See? It's just a program. Yeah, so it totally makes sense that there are energies, you know, affecting us. I mean, what else is affecting us? At any time ever, the only reason you feel a certain way is because of a certain energy. The only reason there is anything ever is because of energy. Energy, 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 energy. It's the only thing that is. It's what's beyond this. Three people called me today. Nobody's called me all week. And I feel different than I did yesterday. It's the stars, man. It's the weather. It's the moon. It's the sun. It's the mood. It's the mind. 100% the mind. It's all in the mind. It's all in the imagination. I've made enough art. But I also haven't made enough with this. That light, I have a relationship with that light. A bit intense, that. This is for you. This is energy for you. It's not for myself. I was bred. Of course it's for myself, like, it's enjoyable and all. And it should be. Anything that you do should be enjoyable for yourself, like that. But, I mean, any sort of work is for the whole. For the rest of yourself. Not this ego. But everyone else. The rest of your body. Your full body. And it should be. And we're going towards a place where it's not only for our species, but for the Earth, because realizing that the Earth is us and realizing that everything else is us, and we can just all help out each other. Optimistic. I'm just a wannabe mystic, creating the world in front of me. But it's a lot of pressure. It's a lot of pressure. It's a lot of pressure to do that. Because what am I basing it off of? You see what this is? This is a fractal. God. You know, God had this much trouble. Look at that. Now she's trying to leave. Oh, maybe not. What's that? That goes into it. Everything goes into everything, of course, but the something from nothing type thing. Like, you gotta have a previous experience in order to create an experience. You have to have a spiritual, personal journey, which, you know, for some people could be watching me, or watching, you know, TV when they were little. It was still personal. It was still in their mind. No matter what, it's in your mind, because it's any model that you look at it from. Rather that's, you know, an internal or external, you know, with the brain, you know, perceiving information. If there actually is an external, it's still going into the mind. So yeah, always mind, always.